So for this course, we tried to match and pair up the cone beam CT and preview or concurrently review those with the dissection. And then that allows us, when we get in clinical practice, to better understand the cone beam and our patient assessment.
And I come in kind of from a alternative point of view, being ENT and sleep, and have worked closely with David for many years because we learned so much from the cone beam in terms of the anatomy that I deal with, and really cross-culturally, if you will, with the dentist, that it's turned out to be very fruitful to look at things from a circumferential point of view, if you will.
And I think today I notice it more than last time. We were able to put a lot of anatomy in clinical context a little better than we did before. And so every time we came upon a piece of anatomy, we talked about the clinical correlations of that anatomy and sort of, I guess, some of the red flags or concern areas that might arise by not really appreciating fully the anatomy.
I have the clinical perspective, and David and I have also often discussed some of the anatomic things that happen when your breathing changes over the years, and what you can see in some of the soft tissues. So it's helpful to correlate those while you're looking at the anatomy and then looking at the abnormal or the normal radiographs.
So this particular course, this time at Anaheim, was basically a general head and neck dissection. The San Francisco course is going to be optimized more to sleep medicine, sleep dentistry, and TMD issues.
And airway.
And so the anatomy will focus more on those and then try and correlate with the clinical. I might come at it from the imaging point of view again, and the kinds of things that we can sense using imaging. Dr. Appelblatt, on the other hand, she sees the patients and she treats the patient, manages them. And her role, I think, in dentistry, we're trying to bring her in to dentistry, but her role might be to help us triage patients so they get the appropriate treatment once the diagnosis has been made.
And then what is Dr. Asadi's role in the class?
He's the anatomist.
That bedrock.
Yeah, he's the glue that puts us all together.
Yes.
We're just the bit players. Okay. And he's one of a kind. He's very energetic, and he just loves anatomy, loves to teach. And he's good at it. And I think for me that the one thing that I would hope attendees would gain from an experience like this would be to overcome their fear of learning again, kind of get in and understand anatomy. And in order to recognize abnormal anatomy, you have to know normal. And that's really the focus of this, is to really understand normal anatomy.
And the head and neck is so rich with interconnected areas and what we call referred pain, and everything relates to everything else. You almost have to look at it from through and through point of view.
One thing I think I'd like to add as the last thing is that Dr. Asadi is engineering some very clever things here, and that he's bringing together sort of disparate experiences to focus on one problem, one issue, is anatomy. So all of us work with anatomy, but through a different lens. So I look at patients through CT scans or MRIs. Dr. Appelblatt does it through surgical eyes, I think, and clinical experience. And Dr. Asadi is the anatomist, and he brings us all together. Hopefully our combined experience and expertise makes a good course.